What's up guys, it's Dash Enforcer here, and today I'm going to show you guys how to install the Police Smart Radio plugin for your LSPDFR. Now this plugin basically makes it a lot easier to use your radio, and it has all kinds of features like running license plates, you can press a distress signal, you can call in for tow trucks, all that stuff. If you want this plugin to work correctly, you are going to need the Traffic Policer plugin, so if you don't have that already, I recommend you go check out my video that I did, show you guys how to install that. If you guys want to see some more videos, and if you guys also want to, you know, give me suggestions for what I should make in the future, I made an official Discord server for you guys to go check out. I'll be leaving all the links down in the description below. But without further ado, let's get straight into the tutorials. So the first thing you guys want to do is go ahead and head over to the link that I left down in the description below. It's going to take you to the lcpdfr.com website, and all you're going to have to do is scroll down until you see Police Smart Radio. This is version 1.2.0.0, so this is made by Albo1125. Just scroll down until you see download this file. Then you're just going to go ahead and click on that. It'll tell you all the download terms, script modification. You can just go ahead and select agree and download. And what you want to do is select the most updated one. So that's going to be the version 1.2.0.0. Always look for these numbers and see which one's higher than the other one. Go ahead and select this one. And it should start downloading, so just wait until that's done installing. You should see it appear on your bottom left hand side of the screen. And once it's done downloading, it should tell you guys. There it is. So it should pop up now. And once it's done, just go ahead and open that. And you'll be brought to this. And it should say the Police Smart Radio right here. Just go ahead and double click on that. And you'll see the API documentation. This just basically gives you the information about like what this plugin does. But for now, you're just going to go ahead and go to your Grand Theft Auto 5 right here and just leave it right here. So the next you're going to want to do, go ahead and head over to your GTA 5 directory. And you're just going to want to open it up. Again, if you don't want to do that, it's Program Files 86. Scroll down to see Steam. You're just going to want to go ahead and go over to Steam Apps, and then you go to Common. Then you go to GTA 5, and here it is. So close that a little bit if it's too big. So the next thing you're going to want to do is open up the files that you just got, and we're going to do it just like we did the last time. This is basically how you're going to install most plugins most of the time. It's really just going to be dragging and dropping unless you have to use OpenIV, which you will for some. And all you want to do now is just go ahead and select these two files, and you're just going to want to go ahead and drag them, drop them right there. And it'll be copying everything and replace the file in the destination if it asks you to. And everything should be copying down, so once that's done, you can go ahead and close out of this. Now, in order to check to make sure that everything worked successfully is go into your directory and go to plugins, and go to your LSPDFR, and you should see this new file called Police Smart Radio, and it'll tell you the audio, the config, everything right here. These are just the configuration settings. You can go to the keyboard configuration settings. This will be your toggle key. So the default is always going to be C, so if you press C, that's going to be your main key to actually bring up the radio. So make sure you have that checked off, like whatever you guys want. Once you're done, you can go ahead and exit out of that, and you can go over to over here, and if you scroll down, you'll see policesmartradio.dll. That's basically going to load in plugin and stuff when you load inside a game. So once you check to make sure you have everything there, you can just go ahead and close out of this, and you are basically done. Now, in order to check that everything's fine, just load up your Rage plugin hook and see how everything runs. Alright guys, so once you got all that set up and you have launched your Rage plugin hook, now all you have to do is just make sure that you are on duty in order for the plugin to actually work. So once you go on duty, all you have to do now is press C, and you should see that little radio pop up on the bottom right hand side. In order to scroll through the options, all you have to do is press T, and it should cycle through like all the options right here. And in order to select one, all you have to do is press Z, and it should do the action for you. So that's basically how you use the Police Smart Radio. If you want, you can go ahead and test it out, like, on some people. You can also check out cars, you can do a plate check. So let's say you want to check out this plate. It'll display it on the left-hand side, tell you what it is, and I'll tell you all the information for the vehicle. So that's like a quicker way of actually checking the license plate, because like if you didn't have this mod, you'd have to go all the way to your police radio, you'd have to do records check, and that just takes a lot of time. So that's the Police Smart Radio. I hope you guys like this video. If you guys want to see some more tutorials, let me know down in the comments below. Make sure to join that Discord if you guys want to be updated with everything, and make sure to subscribe to the channel. I will be uploading a video how to install police vehicle packs and also ELS and all that stuff. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you all have a good day, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.